Clutterbuck injury. What happened? How did it happen? What happens next? Stay tuned to find out. Hey everybody, Dr. Chris, orthopedic surgeon and sports medicine physician. Welcome to my channel, your number one source for information on broken bones and orthopedic injuries that's easy to understand for the everyday man.
That's a little doctor joke we like to make around here.
Cal Clutterbuck is a forward for the New York Islanders, and he was injured on December 19th in a game versus the Boston Bruins. The injury occurred after Clutterbuck struck Patrice Bergeron in the neutral zone. After being struck, Bergeron lost his balance and his skate came up and struck Clutterbuck in the wrist. Clutterbuck was struck at the level of the wrist, just below the glove. Bergeron's skate blade struck Clutterbuck on the volar aspect of his left wrist. And this just means he was struck on the palmar side of his wrist. The skate blade caused a laceration at the wrist that involved the skin and some of the structures laying underneath. There did not appear to be, nor was there reported to be, a vascular injury or an injury to any of the blood vessels. The volar structures of the forearm and wrist are separated into several layers. The most superficial layer includes four muscles: the pronator teres, the flexor carpi radialis, the palmaris longus, and the flexor carpi ulnaris. And these are muscles that are involved in pronation and flexion of the wrist. The second layer involves only one muscle, the flexor digitorum superficialis. And this is a muscle that involves flexion of the fingers. In particular, the flexor digitorum superficialis bends the finger at the PIP, or the proximal interphalangeal joint. If we look at the video, we can see that the laceration occurred on the ulnar aspect of the wrist, or the side of the wrist closest to the pinky finger. The tendons that are present on the ulnar side of the wrist include both the flexor carpi ulnaris and the flexor digitorum. So it's likely that one or both of these tendons was injured by the laceration caused by the skate blade. If the laceration were deeper, it is possible that other structures such as the median nerve might also have been involved as well. So now that we know what was injured, what happened after that? Clutterbuck was taken to the hospital where he underwent emergency surgery. Typical treatment of a laceration would include the administration of tetanus toxoid, the administration of IV antibiotics, and an irrigation and a debridement of the laceration wound. And this just means that they would immunize him against tetanus if his tetanus status were not up to date or were unknown. They would give him intravenous antibiotics to prevent infection from any bacteria that might be contaminating the wound. And finally, they would wash out and clean the wound to make sure that there was no dirt or contaminants in the wound, and to make sure that any damaged or necrotic, meaning dead, tissue were removed from the wound before it was closed. In Clutterbuck's case, he was known to have suffered tendon injury. So the treatment would also include a repair of the various tendons that were injured. And although Clutterbuck himself did not suffer nerve injury, were a nerve injured, then the patient would also undergo a primary repair of that nerve, were it possible. So now that we know the treatment that Clutterbuck underwent, what does this mean for him in the future? Following his surgery, Clutterbuck will be splinted in a functional position for a period of 6 weeks to allow the tendon repair to heal. After the tendon has healed, he will require an extended period of rehabilitation with hand physiotherapy to restore full function of his hand. It is possible that even after healing and physiotherapy has been completed, he may be left with a flexion contracture involving one or more fingers. However, he should be able to return to playing hockey at the previous level without any significant deficits or restrictions. So there you have it. Today we've been talking about the Cal Clutterbuck injury. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and keep your eyes peeled for membership options coming to this channel soon. And as always, that's been the word from Dr. Chris, not your everyday...
Or no, just a flesh wound.